Okay. We had a little technical difficulty earlier, okay?
Reboot.
Oh my gosh. Shout out to Keith for calling me. He's like, "Are you live?" Okay, listen. This is all learning. This is all a learning thing.
And that's why you're
just my mind is just all over the place just because of what has been going on.
And that is completely understandable.
So let me start fresh, okay, before I go live again, because I don't really know. Well, I guess I can.
Back in this thing.
Okay.
Redo.
We got to do a redo. That's fine.
And that's okay.
I have a very special... I can't even talk. I have a very special guest in the building with me, but I'm going to get to her in a second after I make these announcements again, because I'm so slow. Oh, my gosh.
You say again, but don't nobody even know, so it's all good.
Then that's true, I guess. That's true.
Just a little bit.
Okay. So, welcome back to the Queen Pin, you guys. This is Brianna B. It's your girl, Brianna B, a.k.a. your fairy hood mother. And I am here.
I know you lying.
I am here back at it again at the Good News Radio. This is episode 4. And I have a couple announcements to make. Let me make them again. So, on my page, on my Instagram, I am shouting out black businesses. So, what you guys need to do is you need to go to my Instagram. I made a whole flyer today. It's on the Queen Pin Pod, and it's on Brianna.B. And it's also on Facebook, if I have anybody on Facebook. But, so, it's basically essentially just for you guys to showcase your businesses, your black business, your whatever business. I want to just highlight, you know, all the businesses and all of that. So, yeah, yes, so ma'am. Only $5, $5, y'all, for two spots.
Two for five.
I mean, if you want to shout it out, look, can I get a shout out? if you want to, shout your business out and all that type of stuff, just make sure that you hit me up on my email, thequeenpinpod@gmail.com. I would prefer an email. I don't really like DMs like that, because I barely get to them. Anybody that know me know. So
email in my bio.
Yeah, so for five so for $5, two spots on my show. I mean, if you have events coming up, if you have a business, if you have a brand, if anything, if you want to showcase that, hit me up. I want to support as well as get the support, and we can make this thing happen. We can get this shit popping.
Yes, tap in, y'all.
Yes. Okay, so I also have another announcement. So there's a showcase that is September 14th for the Good News Radio. If you want to come out, please come out. It's only it's 150 tickets, I think, that could be sold, if I'm not mistaken. We just had a conference call. I need to be remembering this, okay? The pre-sales are $10 or two for 15, featuring my show, The Queen Pin.
Yes, ma'am.
Which is also on available platforms.
Okay.
I mean, you've seen me posted enough. the doors open at 5:30 p.m. and the venue is in Hollywood. So beware of parking. If you know what Hollywood is like, you already know. And I'm going to post a flyer for that very soon. Probably like soon. So, yeah. So we're going to do that. Let me make sure.
The Queen Pin Spotlight.
If you want to call in, okay, if you want to call in, you can call in 323-900-0478 to join the conversation. 150 total tickets, okay? Yes, 150 total tickets, so yes. And I can't hook you up, so don't even ask. I'm not, no, what? You need
come
to just support.
Now.
You need to just, not be black. Come on now.
You know, just I'm not even going to say don't be black, but y'all be playing around. Y'all be going out. Spending hot dollars on Gucci, Fendi, Prada.
Yes.
But you don't want to spend that on your homie because it's your homie. And you want your homie discount. But your homie got to eat too.
Hello.
And that's without the taxes. So I'm really doing you a favor, okay?
Yes.
Everybody likes that money untouched and under the table. Let's be real.
Exactly.
So
y'all hear this voice in the background. I have a very special guest. I just love her. We just met. We didn't just meet today, but we met in person today.
But met in person, and I like the vibe. Met on social media and instantly knew, like, all right, okay, cool, we're friends.
Yeah.
Want to be friends? All right. Literally slid in the DMs on the friendship shot.
Yes.
And I like to say I scored.
Yeah. So explain who you are, what you do.
Okay. Hello. Hello. And good evening, everyone. My name is Justice Jackson. I am from the IE. Yes, you heard it here live. I am a representative representative, excuse me, of the Inland Empire. Okay, whole lot of unfazed. Shout out to my friends. Shout out to my homies. I am also a model, and I host and curate my own podcast, Say Jackson. We speak all things millennial, just on tabletop conversations and, you know, sharing moments and our experiences to just help and elevate one another on a lot of the things that are going on in this universe that, as being millennials, people don't understand our perspective. So
yes,
it's a good spot for everyone to just come in and have natural table talk. And also on the side of that, I like to write.
Yes.
I like to write poetry. I love to freestyle. I love to be funny on the beat. Play the beat, I might get off. I might say something cool. I might say something lame. I'm expressing myself. And that's what's important.
I'm trying to get this music together. So.
Don't worry. That's my Tinder profile. I'm just playing, y'all.
You know, it's so crazy because, like, I don't really like to, like, I don't know. I don't really use music and all of that. Mm-hmm. Like, ah.
It's a thing. Get nervous.
Y'all,
is
shout out
right
to my
sound?
Guest Justice for just bearing with me.
Yes.
Okay, this is
I
a very learning
one. And you're funny.
I'm funny.
You're extremely funny. You're really goofy, and I love it. I love the humor. Like, yes.
Yes. Oh, my gosh. After all that's going on, I have to laugh. I have to just laugh at myself.
Good.
You know, if it's one thing that the last couple of days has taught me, is just to not keep your personal stuff in your car.
And you know what's crazy? My mom says that to me all the time.
Mm-hmm.
And you would think after getting my car stolen and broken so many times that I've learned,
yes,
I still will walk away from my car with the windows down and things like that.
Yeah,
I like to believe that I'm protected, but I also should have some type of awareness,
mm-hmm,
and not be a fool and roll my windows up and turn my car off and things of that nature.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. It's okay, though.
It's okay.
We're learning.
We're learning.
We have to have the experience in order to understand.
It's all about, that's what life is about. It's
just
all about experiencing
it.
And
just
all of that stuff. Okay. So, I don't know where I'm going to place. You know where I'm going to place it afterwards. So, I'm going to talk a little bit about what happened to me, y'all.
Do we need that moment of silence? Do we need that moment of silence?
Silence is what we need.
We're going to breathe. We're going to woosah.
Okay.
Beforehand.
So, talking about this for... Yes, I'm here for this. So, okay. Look, this is what happened to me. Okay, so I posted a couple days, 2 days ago.
Okay,
somebody busted my window to my car. Oh,
yes. At least it wasn't out of anger. They just wanted something. It's okay.
It was probably homeless.
Stop.
It's a lot of homelessness.
It could have been somebody in a $1 million mansion on that
so
mess.
So let me tell y'all, I was in Santa Monica.
I was
in Santa Monica minding my business. I was with a friend. We was going to the beach. Just a little late night beach. Like, you know, just
creep.
Chill, you know, vibe, eat, you know, all
little
of that.
Regular schmegular things.
No,
it's minding
a little
your
bit.
Business, though. Emphasis on that part.
Minding my business. And it just so happened that I heard an alarm and didn't really think too much about it. And
alarms all the time. You know,
alarms off. And you know, the crazy thing is, though, is that it's very busy. Like, it was like where I parked was very busy down there. It was right by the pier.
Oh,
and
yeah.
So it was by like where, like, the downtown, like the where the shops and stuff
and all
is
the
at
bars
and
all
of
that. Yeah, a whole bunch of stuff going on.
I didn't park in a parking structure. I was out on the street at a meter, parked around a whole bunch of cars. I mean, I'm talking about it's Benzes, it's Mercedes, it's all
Stop.
Different types of
Benzes,
stuff.
Benzes, Mercedes, all that.
They're going to hit
looking at
me.
You, though. They're looking at you. Your vehicle. I want it, need it.
Somebody said, you know what, maybe it's because it was white and it just stood out.
That's what we're not going to do because I have a white car. So we're going to stop.
We're not going to do that.
Because if that's the case, I need my insurance to get on it.
Yeah. So it was very interesting, a very interesting time. I did not notice, once again, until I was in my car and driving.
And I need everyone to pay attention to that detail, though.
Yeah, I didn't know.
She was already driving and still didn't know the
driving.
Window was messed up. It's okay, though.
Already driving.
It'd be like that.
And it was crazy. And I just, you know, felt a breeze. I felt
not
a breeze, and I heard a little, you know,
crack
in the back. I was like, what is this? Are you
driving over something?
And I had to look back. I looked back, and I saw my, I just saw a
passenger.
Hole. I just really just saw a hole, and I said, wow. And I just was really shocked.
Stop and good night. Not, wow.
I was like, wow, this is so crazy right now. Like, what? So... I saw a hole. I like stop. I pull over. The person I was with, they was hot. They was like, "What?" Went back like, "I could get them." Oh, I can. Oh, I'm like, "Oh,
that's cute."
Like, I
that's,
love that energy. You know,
cute.
I need you to be like, you know, lit and all of that. So, yeah, that's what was happening. And then I wanted to go back and I wanted to be
Goodbye.
Mad, but I just really couldn't even be mad.
For
I was
what?
Just like, "Wow!" Like,
you know, it happened. Which what?
why am I mad?
Yeah, because that energy is going to go where?
Because this is the thing. It's like two people's fault in this situation. I mean, one, I'm out of a window. So now that's inconveniencing me. Now yes. I have to get a new window.
This is true.
And this, it's two things that came out of this for me. One, you need to make sure that you definitely have an emergency fund.
That's a good point.
Because
that's a really good point.
Things like this can be very just like,
because you got to cancel all your cards quick. Now you can't do nothing for 24 to 48
You need
hours.
To make sure you have an emergency fund. And then two, you need to make sure you don't keep nothing personal in your car.
You gotta
stop. I don't know what you know, it's crazy because I don't want to, I don't even want to say that I do that all the time, but I kind of, you
it's
know,
a thing. If it's a natural thing.
If you're just going in and you're running in somewhere real quick, especially, you're not really thinking about it.
Okay. Especially with me having these, experiencing the new vehicles, the push to starts. I don't always, I literally will get out of my car and forget to turn it off. And if it didn't go beep, 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 yeah, my car. But
and I forget my keys in my car all the time.
All
so thank
time.
God I didn't do that.
Woo, hot yes. off.
So I had, you know, the good thing is, though, is I had my ID, I had my bank card. I keep all that stuff on me. My purse only had my good lotion that my bestie got me. I'm so sorry, but it's gone.
R.I.P. to the lotion. R.I.P.
I was ashy today. I was like,
okay. Yeet, but you still got a purse, though. Come on now. Recuperate. We got to recuperate.
We got to.
Yeah, I'm going to buy it back two times. I'm going to get two lotions this time.
That's okay. I don't know where to find that, though. But that's okay.
Okay. But that is A-okay. Okay?
You be using that raw shea butter anyway. I got to be using that raw shea butter.
Because it's Mando. It's the air quality is trash, okay? I work with foreign kids, and they always come to me like, my skin is dry.
Yes.
And it is very hot. And I look at them sad.
Yes.
Because I do not know what to do.
Ashy.
I have shea butter on.
I don't know if I did. I put some on today?
No, girl. Today I put on your local, you know,
okay.
Vaseline baby oil thingamajiggy okay. that they sell.
All
whatever
right.
it's called.
Okay.
But that mango shea butter, yes, across from, what is that burger spot? No, I was going to say Monty's. It's not
you
Monty's.
Live out here?
No, I don't. I live in the IE.
You live
but
in the IE?
I come out here enough, especially when it's time to eat.
And you drove all the way out here?
Oh, yes, ma'am.
For
to
me.
Hang out with my friend. Yeah, that's what I do. I want to hang out. So I'm going to come out.
That's
and we're
amazing.
Having fun. And we're talking.
Shout
I love
out.
Conversations. So
I love having conversations.
Yes. So I'm going to come. Yes, I am. Yes, I am. And I'll get here in an hour. Yes, I will. It really
Girl.
Takes, it could take two, depending on the traffic.
Wow.
Yeah, man. It is
First of all,
a hard
hold on.
Thing.
Let me give you a round of applause. These are the types of people you need in your life, honey.
Okay, don't sleep on me, but also sleep on me because I'll get a little nervous meeting all types of new people, okay? All that energy, I don't know.
Yeah.
We really
you just
got to
know energy. You just got to
That's
know.
Really it. It's really got to be aware
exactly.
of that.
Exactly. Yeah.
Hanging out with people and you just be like, oh, you're cool.
So if we got to. We got a chat room, so I'm just, you know, periodically I'm just looking
Hello,
over.
Hello,
my cousin is, hey, Ray, girl.
Hey, Ray. How you
Keith
doing?
Is like, here we go.
Okay. We got it. We're in this thing. We're tapped in. Y'all
We're
can
here.
Hear us. We're live. Don't say the same thing as me at
oh
the same time.
Oh, my gosh. Okay.
Get out of my head.
Okay, so to get this show started, I want to, you know, I introduced what I want to do for Black businesses. So I'm going to call this the Queen Spotlight
yes,
of the Week.
Queen
so,
Spotlight of the Week.
We have a Queen Spotlight of the Week. This episode is brought to you by QS Simple Treasures Greetings and Collections. Okay? QS Simple Treasures Greetings and Collections. You know when someone is like sick or like a loved one is going
special.
Through something and you just want to just say some words of encouragement or you just want to, you know, you just want to give somebody some love for the day. That's
make
exactly what
nice.
This is.
Maybe you need to make up to your partner.
Yes.
You messed up. You need
QA.
To say something.
Quanda R. Graves, also known as author and poet, has created her very own staple called QS Simple Treasures Greetings and Collections, which is a company dedicated to greetings and gift ideas. The motto is you don't need a holiday to celebrate a loved one. Simple Treasures are small greetings with big sentiments at golden age prices that won't break the bank. Okay. Isn't that amazing?
Absolutely it is.
We don't need that to break the bank.
Don't forget about my bank. Please don't break my pockets.
Please.
My bank is my last resort. My pockets is really what I'm trying to depend on.
Exactly.
Okay?
Clear and concise with heart and mind. Their website is www.untilnomore.net and you can follow them at QS Simple Treasures on Instagram and Facebook at Simple Treasures QS. Again, www.untilnomore.net. Get them greeting cards.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay.
Simple Treasures, we know how you feel, so we know what to say.
And I love that. I love that. Yes. Because sometimes I don't know what to say. So somebody else please figure it out.
Yes.
Because sometimes, I don't know if about you, but there's just sometimes where you know you need to apologize or you know you're in the wrong and you're too busy being in your own ego.
Right.
And you're too busy being a jerk that you're just like, I'm not going to say that. Or you just don't know what to say. You're just not ready to say it. So why not have somebody else write something?
Why not have somebody?
Plagiarism, a little ghetto, but that's okay. Because even though it's not from me, it's from someone.
And see,
who does
these
care.
Though that I think you write your own. You write your own like greetings and all that
oh,
type
sweet.
Of stuff. I mean, like, say somebody got you a job, and you want
to,
you're like, oh, let me get
self care.
I gotta say something. I want to say something. I want to have a gift. I want to do something like that.
Something
this is
cute.
Exactly what this is. So make sure you go to that website. And yes, that was the Queen Spotlight of the week. We're gonna do more of these. We're gonna do more of these. The more you guys, you know, put in your businesses, the more I can, you know, shout y'all
as
out
you
and
should,
all that type of stuff. It's only
listening.
$5, 2 spots per episode, and the best thing about it is that it's getting played
repeatedly
twice actually
okay.
in a 3-day span. Ooh, so your $5 is going a long way. People who hear it on, you know, Spotify, Apple Music, and all that type of stuff,
they will travel.
Good.
Everybody needs a greeting card.
Yeah, exactly.
Everybody needs nice things. Self-care.
Yes.
Okay, don't forget about yourself. If no one's sending it to you, send it to yourself. A nice message from yourself is always needed.
Yes, exactly. So I've been a little in a space.
Okay.
You know.
Haven't we all? Don't we all?
We've all been in a space. I've been in a little bit of a space. And
what's that space? What you doing
I don't
in that
know.
Space?
But you know what though? I don't know if it's like, see today, like I feel like I can't sit down and I don't know. I feel like if I sit down too long, if I'm by myself too long, then I start feeling like the depressed and the all of that type of stuff. And
sad
I don't really
girl
know
gang,
if
that's
it's,
what I call
I don't know if it's like the depressed and all of that,
no.
But it's just weird because I'm always on the go. I'm
it's
always
like a state
doing
of
something.
Limbo. That's what I feel like. It's a state of limbo, and especially if you are always doing something, you're always moving. That moment you finally get to sit, it's so unfamiliar to you because you're like, I could be doing something right now, number one.
Right.
And two, what is it I could be doing? So now, instead of you just relaxing and being in that moment and being present, you're so busy, like, thinking of things in the future or thinking of things in the past that you've done. And that's also working. Yeah. And you need to just have moments to just
relax.
But I also,
that's why I took these 2 days off because I was like, I need a moment, especially after this window situation. And it's still not fixed, y'all. I just want to let y'all know it still ain't fixed.
Oh,
so if
is.
You do know
don't
somebody, let me tell you something. If you do know somebody who does windows for the low, please hit me up because I've been calling around and trying to get some good quotes. So if you know somebody in the hood, that
somebody.
Would be greatly appreciated.
Girl, they all because around. They all around. Somebody will hook you up for that. I think that was in Bakersfield. She got hers fixed for maybe like $30.
Yeah.
Girl, go to, excuse my language, Juan, Tito, one of them.
Yeah.
They will help you.
It's one across the street that, you know, they keep telling me about and all of that. So, yeah. I mean, they from the
you'll,
house.
You'll
so.
Do your research, but it's better when you just pull up to the place like, hi.
Hey, Kirsten girl.
My window got broken into. I need that.
Yeah. I had
help me.
Sign my Instagram page. I'm so done. It is a lot going on.
Sign my Instagram page.
Okay.
Being in the spaces.
Yes. But I wanted to tie it to Euphoria. If anybody out there listens to Euphoria, like, ain't that what it's called?
Yeah, Euphoria.
Okay,
yeah,
I'm about to say,
HBO.
Wait.
Yes, absolutely. She had that mama like, yes,
no, I was
Euphoria.
Watching it today. That's why I was thinking about it. And me and you had a brief conversation just a couple of days ago about like a transition and all of that type of stuff.
Yes,
and
yes.
I think that's amazing because it can, you know.
You become aware. When you feel that transition, it's like you're almost another level of you becoming aware because you're like, okay, things are happening in my life and I'm not quite sure what exactly they are, but it's something going on. And the more you tap into what is exactly going on and start doing that research, you start looking at things and reading things like, oh, that's what this is. That's what I'm feeling. This is why this is happening. And it's a part of coming into an alignment.
If you haven't watched Euphoria, you need to watch it because it is an amazing.
It's good.
I think it's really good.
So I'm not going to lie to y'all. I only watched the last episode and I watched the second episode today. But I'm backwards when it comes to reading. I can read the end of the book and then piece everything together and it all
crazy.
Makes sense. Yeah, I came
that's
out feet first, girl. I came out feet first when I was born. But yeah, so that show. definitely everybody doing their thing. It gives you the, everyone's got their story.
And I like how they, like, when it starts, they kind of give you a piece of what, who, what characters, what, and all of that. And I like that. I was like, wow, I didn't really think, I kept hearing about it. And Angela Yee, she keeps saying, you for you? I'm like, let me watch
everyone's,
this show.
Let me see what everyone's talking about. Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
The hype.
So, yeah, I think that show was, like, really pretty cool. So it has a lot to do with, you know, just the...
our teenager phases. Being in a teenager phase.
I mean, and then just going into adulthood and all of that.
Yeah. Because weren't they graduating?
I'm going to be honest with you. I'm on, like, episode 4.
Okay.
This is so wild. Every time. I love it. I have anxiety watching it.
It's good because you don't know what's going to happen.
You don't know.
And you know what's crazy? A lot of people that I know that were actually tapped in, that last episode, but I'm going to let you get there. I'm not even going to spoil it for you.
You know what, though? I think I was on episode 5 and then...
How many episodes is it?
I think 8 or 9.
Oh, okay.
Right? Somebody tell me how many. I'm on my way. But I turned it off today because I was kind of like, I don't feel like watching this no more. But it was like when the... what's his name? I need to know his name.
See?
Not the only black one. He wasn't the twins.
The black
though.
Boyfriend?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Him.
Oh, okay. So I just finished episode 2.
Please don't kill it. Oh, it's only 2.
This
okay,
is 2.
Okay,
this
okay.
is only 2. When okay. when she he was talking to the girl, his girlfriend at the time. Mm-hmm. He was trying to talk about his feelings and how he really felt about, I guess, the coach, whatever was pissing him off. And old girl was trying to get nasty. And he said, "Why every time I'm trying to talk to you, you want to get nasty?" And I said, "That's right. Mm-hmm. Let her know about herself because I'm trying to express something to you, and you over here trying to get freak nasty. Right. It's not the time.
Not freak nasty."
And then when she turned around and was like, "You know, stop it." He tried to tap on her like, "I'm sorry," and she was like, "Don't touch me." I said, "Oh, the audacity of you!
The audacity!
Okay.
Wow!"
And that's as deep as I got.
The
to that
audacity! Oh my God! So yes, agree. Look, I'm in the chat room. I'm on live. It's a lot of stuff going on right now.
All conversations. We're in all projectiles.
It's a lot of stuff going on right now. If you guys want to call in, please feel free. 323-900-0478. 323-900-0478. Call in. Join the chat. If you have the app, join the chat room. Please join the chat room. That's what it's here for. Want you to talk and have conversations. We wanted it to be engaging and all of that type of stuff. So do that.
We would like to hear from you. What you thinking?
Yes, since I messed this up, I wonder how much time I have now. Wow. Don't know.
Okay,
gonna so just wing
thing.
It.
<Still in this thing.
laughs> Yes. Okay. So let's kind of talk about the transition. So I think this episode might be a little bit of a more like on the...
We're just going to get a little deep.
A little deep.
That's okay.
We want to have a mental check-in. I think mental check-ins are important. I think it ties into Euphoria just because it's a lot of stuff going on that show and everybody is mentally distraught from something.
Woo, because the sun, okay, but I'm not even going to start on that.
Yes, okay.
The sun, but.
So let's start with you. What space are you in?
So my space that I would... The best way for me to describe it is just a surreal ego check. Mm-hmm. And I feel like for me, ego death is a constant thing, but right now it's just been really heavy for me. Mm-hmm. Just a couple of weeks ago, I had an incident where, you know, I get off work, it's early, it's like 2:00. The homegirl, she asked me like the day before, to go out. And I was like, nah, you know, I'm good. Like, I'm good off everybody. I'm not going nowhere no more. Decided to change my mind, decided to go out. Okay, cool. I'm just here chilling. Didn't even go to the party with no makeup. Went straight, all natural. Like, I'm just here to chill. Mm-hmm. Long story short, you know, when I go out, I like to just be in my own little spot, just minding my business, you know. Hoorah, hoorah, okay, whatever. So I happen to know the DJ and I happen to know the host. So they're my homies. I'm like, I'm gonna go support whatever the case.
Okay.
So as everyone knows, in this time, unfortunately, our millennials, we are practicing in cucumber challenges.
Mm-hmm.
If you have not seen that on social media, and you're getting a little raunchy.
I think we all have seen it.
Exactly.
It's a little ghetto out here.
It's a little wild.
It's a little wild.
So they decided we're going to go viral, and we're going to go ahead and have a cucumber party. So I'm like, okay, you know, do y'all thing. It has nothing to do with me, but do y'all thing. So my homie, he comes up. He's like, yo, can you help me? Da-da-da. I'm like, okay, he's walking around with these cucumbers. You're about to go to women walking around with cucumbers. This is a little strange, a little aggressive. So in my head, I'm like, okay, well, you know, I'll go for support for the women. Maybe they'll feel comfortable if they see a woman, they see whatever. This is just my thought process. I'm not thinking nothing into it. So we're going around. Eventually, you find a couple of women who would like to participate. Do your thing, girl. Do your thing. I'm not here to judge you. I don't mind at all. So they're doing their thing. I'm recording videos for the homies. So he's a host. This is what he does. So I want him to get good content. So here's my bald head self all in the video. Like, yeah, girl, do your thing.
Not bald head.
That's me. Faded for days. Okay, fades for days.
She does have a fade, y'all.
I do have the wave. She does. You can't get the wave check if you come on Instagram Live. Brianna's or mine. It can happen. But nonetheless, yeah, so pretty much I'm in the viral. I'm in the video, and it ends up going like kind of mini viral. Everyone's seeing it. So I'm getting people I haven't talked to in months. I'm getting text messages on my phone from people who aren't even saved in my phone. Look at you in this video. Da, 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 da. I'm like, yo, whoa. Like, I started thinking of how everyone feels about that. And I'm just like, okay. In my head, I'm like, I'm just supporting her. Like, it wasn't a big deal. You know, that's just me. I'm in the cut, minding my business. But everyone's like, look at how you look, though.
Right.
You're surrounded by this type of business. So my agency hits me up. And they're like, yeah, this is not the type of foolery you need to be a part of while branding your name. So I'm like, whoa.
Mm-hmm.
So this is where my ego comes into play, because I'm like, everybody trying to tell me about me. I'm just here chilling. This is what I do. I just be chilling. I'm just here to support.
Right.
But whole time, I'm not realizing me as a representation of others.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm like, okay, whoa. So whole time I'm at this battle with myself of my ego being like, this is who you are. You're a supporter. You didn't do anything wrong. But then the other part of me is like, you do have to look at your image and how people are going to see you and what they will associate with. Even if my attitude is, you know, I don't care. I don't, you know, IDGF, like whatever. That's just me. I'm doing what I do. I have to care to some extent. So I started thinking like, okay, do I really want to be in the industry? Do I really want to be out here? People can just look at me. I'm having a whole Frank Ocean moment. Like, okay, forget social medias. I'm like, let me delete my Twitter. Let me go make a new Twitter. Like just a whole rabbit hole of just everything that I'm thinking about. So that caused me to just completely tap out. I was like off social media.
Wow.
I didn't want to go out. I didn't want to hang out with anybody because I'm at war with myself. And now I'm like, who am I? That was my question.
Yeah.
I started to really think like, if I can't be this person who gets to express myself in the way I want with having the attitude of, okay, IDGAF or I don't care or whatever, like this is me and I'm
IDGAF.
I don't want you to blank it out or anything.
You can look.
I
didn't know. I know people be like, can I?
Because I need to know. I don't want you to go back and edit it or blank
explicit,
it out.
You know what I'm saying?
Okay, makes sense then. But yes, my attitude is I don't give a fuck. Like, because I'm just me and I'm an individual and I'm not represented by anyone else. But that's really not the case when living in this world. We're all a representation of each other, and that's just what it is. So yeah, it put me in this space of what I call a sad girl gang, where I'm not like depressed or anything, but I'm just out of it. I don't want to create nothing. Nothing is driving me for anything. I have no motivation. I don't do nothing. I don't do shit. I just want to sit here and listen to The Weeknd and just stare at the sky and be left alone. But I had to come out of that, and I realized it was a transition of me realizing that it's not about me. It's not about my ego. It's not about how I see I am. It's not about the thoughts that I create of who I am. It's about all of us.
Mm-hmm.
And it's about this full representation. So even with that being said and me stopping to hang out with my friends, I was realizing like my friends would come to me with their issues and I would be turned up.
Uh-huh.
Oh yeah, this girl did this. Me, fuck that bitch. Yeah, forget her. And I'm just making all these assumptions about situations and I'm putting facts behind them or trying to make them valid through my friends. So then that's why I had to cut my friends off for just the time being, because I was like, you guys are a representation of my ego as well.
Right.
You guys, and they're unknowing. They don't know it that they're doing this, but I know it. And I'm seeing how each and every one of them is a representation of my ego. So I had to get out of that. And I had to come back to who am I? What am I doing? How am I feeling? And, you know, it even got down to just talking shit. I had to watch my mouth. I need to watch my mouth when I'm talking about other people. And so now when I'm saying something or if I'm driving in traffic, cussing people out, I'm like, you know what? That's my ego.
Mm-hmm.
Because I know I'd be on bullshit, too. And that's just the whole play.
Yeah.
I know I'd be on bullshit, too. So I don't have room to say nothing about nobody or anything. So because of that, and I'm seeing the full circle of, okay, I be on it. Y'all be on it. So we both on it. And I shouldn't be looking at like, y'all. It's just us.
Mm-hmm.
So now I definitely feel better. I definitely feel good about myself again. I don't know. I don't have any thoughts of who I should be. I just feel like I am.
That's
and I'm
good.
Being and I'm present. So.
Oh, that's deep.
Yeah. I had to end it on that one. I was feeling it. I said, okay, winding down, and done.
It drops the mic.
That's
okay.
It.
Anyways.
Yes.
So, I don't know. I guess, like, mine is, like, I'm just kind of just here. I think just going through the process and going through the transition of just life and, you know, dealing with different things. I feel like I'm kind of behind on things. You know, you get to that point, like, how old are you?
25.
Okay.
Yeah, 25. Okay. 25.
So being in our 20s, I think it's just a lot of, you know, trying to think that you need to be somewhere so fast, but you don't really, you know, like,
yes, Lord.
I feel like I should be at a certain place and I'm only 20 something, you know? And, you know, it's like, so I'm always like stressing myself out about, and I, like, I'm not even a stressed out person. Like, I don't really be stressed. I really be chilling, but like when it comes down, yeah, I think a lot, I'm an overthinker. And so I'm always like, okay, I need to do this. I need to do this. I need to do this. I finally got me a planner. So I can, you know, just
organize. See your visual thoughts that you're making.
Yeah, and then knock them off, you know, to-do list. I have a little to-do list.
And it feels good.
It does feel good.
It feels so good to cross that out, even though you have, like, 20 more things.
Yes.
But this one right here, though.
It feels good to cross that
crossing
off.
Crossing it out.
Yes.
And I deserve something every time I do. That's really how I think about it.
What's the topic? The topic is we're just doing a mental health check-in today. We're doing a mental health check-in. So I kind of tied it into Euphoria. If you watch Euphoria, once again, you know what that show is about. And everybody's going through something. They all need to be checked into something.
So not just in dad. Everybody needs to be checked in.
Yes. So, yeah, I'm just kind of like in a space where I'm like, I need to be doing this. I need to be doing that. Trying not to stress myself out. The whole car thing was just an inconvenience. It's just extra. I'm like, oh my God.
Me getting
so
these
thirsty.
Ghetto parking tickets. Girl, don't
I got so many tickets.
Let me
tell you
something. Myself up.
When I take my car to go get, when I go get my registration renewed. It's going to cost me more than what. I just had to pay $600 with them.
Girl. Literally just got my ass chewed out by my mom. Like, you and these parking tickets? I'm like, man, she tripping. here go me at We Jam. Let me just go get some food. I get the food.
I haven't been there yet.
Girl, well, I go to We Jam and Cafe. There's two. There's the restaurants and then there's the cafe.
Okay.
The cafe sells breakfast and it is bomb. They open at 11 and are busy by 10:30.
Okay.
They are fire.
Wow.
The restaurant's also good as well. That's just like your regular Jamaican
people
food.
Overhype it up.
Yeah, the We Jammin' restaurant, definitely.
People
but that
like
cafe, though, no, it's not a joke. That cafe is fire. That French toast with the cereal, Fruity Pebbles to be exact. Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
She said, let me hop on that app. Look,
get into it, y'all. Tap into it. Live
Tap
and direct.
Tap into it. Listen, y'all need to be downloading this. I'm going to say it again.
Been
okay?
Saying it.
I'm on my live, so I'm trying to tell everybody, like, listen, y'all got to be, you know.
Get with it.
Or. Yes.
Get right on.
So, yeah, we're just doing, like, a little mental check-in
mental
today.
Mental health check-in. They're important. Everyone feels like they have to have their mental check-ins alone in isolation, but sometimes you need to just, I need to talk to somebody.
Mm-hmm.
And I feel like the fact that just in this time we vouch a lot of our issues to our friends, which is good, but I feel like when you vouch your feelings and what you're going through to someone who may not know you're something, it's so much more better just because it's an unbiased opinion.
Right.
They don't know nothing about you from Timbuktu, which is why we should go to therapy.
Right.
What? Let me find out. I could go to my therapist. I'm spilling it all, okay? All the childhood trauma. I'm not telling nobody else, though.
You have a therapist?
No, and I need to get
you
one.
You need to get one. I need to get one.
Crazy when I was going to school.
Shout out to Never Not Extra.
Well, yes, I love those ladies.
I forgot which one of them. Hit me up. I don't know. I don't know which one hit me up. I forgot which one. I think it was Monty. I think it was Monty that hit me up, but about a therapist. So I did call that lady, and she was real sweet.
Yes.
She was like, okay, that's going to be $150 per session. I said, oh, I'm going to just check back in.
Girl, did you hear my deep breath? Everybody, because what do you mean? Can y'all just listen to me? Why are you trying? Just listen to me.
She said, well, do you have insurance? I said, yeah. It was me, Monty.
I think so.
Yes.
I'm like, I hope so.
Yeah.
I hope so.
I was like,
But even with having, you know what's crazy? Having insurance and trying to get a therapist, still very costly.
Really?
Yes, very
costly.
If you have
insurance, how much would you have to pay out of pocket, do you think? Some of them cover it, but I don't know if my job does.
I feel like even if they do cover it, I feel like you have a minimum amount of how many times you can go and see them. Like, I don't know. I feel like there's a little necessary.
Yes. I think that having a therapist is necessary everything. I mean, especially with everything that's going on in the world.
Yep.
Like,
you're feeling
it needs to be in school. It needs to be in work. It needs to be free.
Yep.
To a certain, I mean, free-ish. Like,
free-ish,
you know,
because
I get
do,
it.
We
you
do
still,
gotta support them. Yeah, yes, you do gotta we do have them. To do. It's crazy because my school, when I was going to school at Cal State Bakersfield, they had actually were like, "Yeah, you know, we have therapists that you can see one time out of the school year."
Yeah,
I said, "But what about them other days that I'm first of all, I'm in school. I'm going not in just school, college." Mm. I need to talk to her all the time. Let's make this a class, matter of fact.
Yeah.
But shout out to my workout class beforehand, so I didn't have to go to my therapist. I was just raising my endorphins, going to the gym.
Oh, yeah. That's, trying to bust it down. That can be a therapist
the gym
for
is
you.
It. Oh, yes.
The gym. Dance. I haven't been to the gym in a minute.
I went yesterday, and the stairs busted me up. tore me up, and I was sad, but I had to get it in.
I need to go to the gym. I'm getting a little pump. Okay.
I'm thick.
A little pump.
I'm a little thick, a little
it's
juicy.
It's not wrong with a little juicy. Ain't it's okay. It's not.
Okay. Gives the eyes. Ain't nothing wrong, honey.
They may like it. No.
Sure do. All yes. No one gets it. No one doesn't count in that. All yes. Tapped in. Thickness is where it's at.
It's where it's at.
When you petite women, is that women?
So what do you think are some ways that you, you for yourself deal with things like how you cope with, like, you know, mentally, like, maybe, like, for me, I might write in a journal. Mm-hmm. It helps if I, like, write things down, and, you know, stuff like that. So what do you think that you do in order to keep
my
your
sanity,
life together,
keep it together? One, I definitely have to just really tell myself, take it easy, chill out, tell my ego, be quiet. I know I messed up. I don't need to hear that. I know I got my second parking ticket in a week. I know that. Chill out.
Yeah.
I'm working on it. So
just
I have to let myself.
Self-control.
Yeah, just be easy on myself. Know that I don't have to be so hard. Mm-hmm. Also, like I said, go to the gym. Got to raise my endorphins. Got to do something that's keeping me pumped up. Sometimes, you know, do a little self-indulgence. Drink a little wine. I might smoke a little blunt. You know, put my summer walker on and get to dancing in the mirror. Make myself feel good. Whatever makes me feel yummy inside. It makes me feel colorful. Sometimes I like to freestyle. Like you said, sometimes I'll write. Sometimes I'll make a podcast that I won't even air out. I'll just make one to talk my shit.
Yeah.
And then I might listen to it. Maybe, maybe not. But I have, just things that make me feel. I used to like to drive and just get on the freeway and coast until, you know, gas started going up and I had to pay for that and things of that nature. So I had to minimalize. Okay, we're not going to just go for a drive.
Right.
But yeah, just. Or going to nice views. That's my favorite thing to do. I love looking at, like, mountaintop views, hillside views, and stargazing over things.
Oh, yeah. Going to the beach.
Yeah. Be careful when you go to that beach, y'all.
Okay, freestyle, LOL. Okay, Issa.
I'm weak, not Issa.
Don't go to the beach. Don't get a Santa Monica beach, okay?
Look, and make
it's
sure you pay
canceled.
Your parking meters. Pay your parking meters,
nah.
Y'all.
Santa Monica beach is canceled. I don't care what nobody's saying.
Cancel culture. We're canceling Santa Monica. We're done with it.
Okay. Somebody said, "Hey, beautiful. Haven't seen you since high school. You got to tell me who you are because I can't even. If I click out of this, it's over with. So just tell me because I can't
seen
even see.
Since high school.
Pretty much.
What's up?
High school. That's Georgia.
So you've been watching? You've been tapped in?
Oh, my gosh.
What are your mental check-ins? You write? What else do you do? You laugh. I noticed that. You laugh at your situation, which is very healthy.
I laugh
healthy.
A lot.
Gotta laugh at your humility. Yes.
Oh, my. Hey. Yes, I do laugh. I laugh a lot about.
It's important. It's a good cure.
Everything. Because if I sit around and just mope about it, like, I'm somebody who can just kind of just go, like, it's just. It's something else. You know, like, I think I always look at stuff as, like, things could be worse. You know, if somebody that's dealing with somebody worse.
Yes,
so
ma'am.
My whole life could have been in my purse. You know, and it wasn't. Yep. It don't matter.
Another
you know?
One, another quote, it'd be like that.
It's just the fact that, you know, you have to go through the process of getting a window. Like, why did it?
Yep.
This is why I'm like,
be
I
looking
need
around
a man
pissy.
In my life to just be like, babe, I'm finna just
Listen,
take the car.
Man or woman, whatever one of y'all want to help. Okay? Okay? I'm not even going to describe whoever. My hand is open.
Somebody who just wants to just take my car the other day and just be like, you know, I just want to just.
I'm going to go ahead and get this fixed, get you a car wash in the detail.
and get the tent back on there, because now I'm going to have one window that ain't got no tent.
Because facts. Oh, my God. It's okay, then. That's so good. At least now they'll have the gateway entry to see ain't nothing in here.
Ain't nothing. And I took everything out of my car.
I'm like, they say we're not supposed to leave stuff in our car, but if we get pulled over, you got to have your registration and insurance.
Exactly.
So am I supposed to keep that in my purse? Because sometimes I don't travel with my purse.
Exactly.
So where do we go from here?
Exactly. Well, they got what they wanted.
Bastards.
The pink purse, if y'all see it in the streets of LA, please let us know in Culver City to be exact.
I know it's Santa in one Monica. Of my pictures on Instagram.
It is a pink purse. Does it have fuzz? Is it leather?
I love that purse.
I'm telling you, you're going to see it. The fiend's going to be walking around looking good, okay? Probably got a whole fit from somebody else's car. Little do you know.
I'm probably not the only car that got hit that day. I heard an alarm, man. Not my man. I
didn't think it was yours.
I didn't think it was
whole play.
Alarms go off all the time.
You know, it's crazy that you say you felt your alarm, because I remember how I told you at the same time last year. Actually, even the year before, my car got stolen. Amps, radio, pick apart on my car. That's what everybody was playing. Pick apart on my car. It's cool. My daddy a mechanic, so I was coming back from that. No, it's good, because this year we're blessed with the 2019. The dash is digital. All the miles put on by me. Yes,
oh,
ma'am.
Wait a minute.
Yes, ma'am. The comeback.
Come on now.
What? Come on. Girl, what? What? Because I'm not going to lie. You have to take 2 days off. I had to sit in my closet for like a good 3 hours and just cry.
Wow.
Came out of my closet a whole new person, okay? Closet of Narnia. I went there. Straight to Narnia and came back a better person.
Straight to Narnia.
I said, okay,
that's
cool.
Amazing.
Yeah. I was on the train, bro. I was taking the bus, Ubers, and...
Oh, no.
Not oh, no.
I just would be like, I just tell my job I can't go to work because I'm not doing that. I'm not paying for that. Unless y'all pay for my Ubers to get to work, I'm not doing it. I'm not coming. I'm sorry.
Thank God my job was not too far, so I was definitely walking up the hills, getting my workout.
I work in Westwood. I work right by UCLA. So it's not that far from where I stay at, but with traffic, that's 45 minutes. With an Uber, 45 minutes, that's a lot of money.
Yeah.
Back and forth. And
Wait, 45 minutes in the Uber? Yeah, that's a minute. Lot. We're not doing that.
That's a lot.
We're not doing that. But comeback game's still strong. Window will be fixed. Window is fixed. Not the way you want it, but it's fixed.
Right now. Look, it's a little temporary fix. Shout out to my uncle for helping me out in temporarily fixing my window. Yes, it stayed. It did not fly.
Because you could have the duct tape. You could be one of them.
I was like, wow.
You could be the duct tape girl person.
It's a little tape on there, though, but you can't see it.
Can't see it, though. Still plexi.
It don't even matter. If you're just tuning in, make sure you call in. You can call. I don't really... Call in 323-900-0478. Please make sure that you join the chat. I see you guys are messaging me on the chat and on my live. I'm going live for the first time because I'm like, I need to do videos.
Tap in so everyone can see. Okay, put a face to the voice so y'all know what's going on.
I don't even know. Like, every single time I get in front of this mic, it's like I have like this brain just like fart. And I'm like, I be knowing what I want to talk about. But then when I get here, it's like,
Literally.
I got a whole outline, everything.
Yes,
but I'm like,
I will though, for my own, same. I feel you on that. And I thought it was just me. And be nervous. Be completely by myself. Nervous as hell. Like, have a whole outline. Let me talk about this. Right. And then end up going on a tangent about something else.
Yeah.
It's all in relation, though. We can always bring it back.
It just kind of just flows. Usually when I have guests, it just kind of just like...
Because we chilling. It's a vibe.
It's a vibe. The music is gone. I don't really feel like dealing with it right now.
We were experimenting very much so during this session. We were experimenting. So now you know, okay, music, we might just throw it in there. Yes. And we're just going to call that a day. Yes. But everything else...
You got to come back up here and chill with me, girl.
You know I will. My hour drive. I'm on my way. We're having fun. Okay, listen. Y'all hearing us now? And the next thing you know, we're going to be out. And y'all be like, well, look at them. Yes, I shot my friendship shot and I scored. Hey, bae. Bae's on my life. I love her.
Yes. it's kind of like,
it's like, era. So now. Okay. So you did ask me, okay, what should we talk about? So... Mm-hmm. My thing that I've been wanting to talk about on my own podcast, what I've been talking about with my friends, Instagram posts, Twitter questions. Mm-hmm. What is your process before you get into a relationship? And what I mean by that is we'll have the talking stage, we have the dating stage, and then we have relationship.
My favorite subject.
Girl, I love it. Because let me tell y'all, this talking mess threw it out the window a long time ago. We don't talk. I don't know what that is, and I'm not doing that.
You know what? Before I answer that.
Okay.
I'm just starting
to
think.
Should we status check?
No, I'm starting to think that this podcast is about to be a relationship. Every single time I have a guest, they're like, so you dating somebody? I'll be like,
they would like to know. Okay. Stop it.
Anyways, that's not a.
Everybody
knows. No, I'm all about being transparent.
Yes.
For sure.
Honesty, communication.
So, what's
your
first step?
Yes, what is your step process before you get into the relationship?
Okay, so I'm a Taurus, and people know when I like relate to that.
You're a Taurus. My partner's a Taurus, and I didn't realize how much I love them. I love them a lot. Y'all nonchalant, y'all jerks, but y'all know how to handle this Gemini, so I dig it.
You're a Gemini?
Yes.
What Gemini?
June 19th, Independence Day for my people. Yes, absolutely.
Okay, I had another June Gemini on the last episode.
Gang.
Y'all are cool, because y'all closer to Cancer.
Look at that face.
Y'all closer to Cancer, so y'all are cool.
I do have Cancer in my birth chart.
Yeah. So, okay, so I would say that mine is, I move slow. That's why I reference Taurus, because I feel like we move slow at everything for the most part. Mm-hmm. I definitely move slow at everything that I do. Hey, my B-Day is June 20th.
Hey.
I definitely move very slow whenever I'm doing anything. Well, relationship-wise, I just feel like I'm probably somebody, like, it's weird for me because I don't like people right off the rip. Like, it got to take some time.
Gosh, like, I don't really. So like my girl.
I don't like people off the rip. Like, I got to get to know you, like, mm-hmm. on a deeper level mm-hmm. Before, like, because I'm very good at compartmentalizing, too. I'm very good at compartmentalizing my feelings, everything. So, like, I could be hanging out with you, chilling with you, texting you every day, and you won't even know I like you like that because I'm just not.
Jerk.
I'm not.
Jerk. Tell me what's going on in
that.
There.
I'm just not, you know, it just.
You might not be the one. I can't let you know, thinking that you are the one. Then you do something to turn me off, and now you really blew it.
Exactly.
Now you think you're the one, and the whole time you're done for.
But see, I think like dating now is like people don't really take it too serious, and it's not enough time to get to know somebody for real. Mm-hmm. Like people are so quick to just jump to it. Like they just want to jump into it or just jump to whatever it is, whether it's
sex, but then have these qualifications. Like okay, that's where my thing
the qualifications
is.
Like mm-hmm. where like for a partner. Like,
not even qualifications for the partner, mm-hmm. but just like, what are the details of what you guys are doing? But see, you're transparent, so you're probably very open about communicating what it is that you guys are doing.
Yeah.
Whether you guys, okay, we're talking, and this is what's allowed in us talking. Because some people are like, okay, well, if we talk, only me and you talk, and that's out for me. If we talk, I could talk to whomever I want, and that's just what it is, and that's just what it's gonna be. And I also feel like the same way for dating. But again, that goes back to me being open. I feel like with talking, I don't really have to tell you I'm talking to someone else because we're just talking, which I also feel like is a term that was created by the Black population and the younger culture.
What is talking?
Okay. So
somebody let me know what talking is.
Let's talk about
that. Because I think talking is like, it's more like,
it's lame.
We just, you know, we're just getting to know each other. We might have conversations on the phone. I might talk to you every day.
Mm-hmm.
But it's just like, we might hang out. We might do shared interests. We might do stuff like that.
That's it. Friend.
But
buddy.
You're my friend. You're
buddy.
The homie, you're, to be honest.
Buddy.
And that's what I be telling people. And it's so funny because I be telling people like, you the homie. You really the
that's
homie
it.
Because this.
And I don't know why people hear that.
It's
and
not.
They're just like, aw. You're lucky
exactly.
you that.
You are lucky you are that.
You could.
And everybody
not
is not even invited.
To be the homie.
To be.
But okay. But okay though. I feel like talking is, it's all good until people start creating these rules and, okay, you talking to me, but you got to tell me you're talking. No, I don't have to tell you anything when we're talking.
So it's talking, and then I saw a meme actually about this.
Yes.
Is it that meme where it was like a checklist or something? It was like, oh, we're talking, we're dating.
Girl, I get so tired of seeing people post these stupid memes that don't apply to them. Be quiet.
Yeah, I don't know. I'm like,
I don't know. I feel like it's, for me personally, just as I've been growing, the talking stage is out for me. I don't do that.
The talk. Well, you know what though?
I
would say I give you like a 30-day probation. You got to make it through
that
30.
We can do that.
We can do a 30-day probation.
Really though.
And you have to be consistent. Like, don't be consistent and then be inconsistent. Like, you need to be. I'm gonna need you to be.
Because is that talking?
That's not talking.
Yeah, you being inconsistent. We're having a conversation. Talking is something that's currently
continuous.
Exactly.
You get a 30-day probation.
That's it.
and then we gonna see.
But
if
like you
make
said,
it.
Yeah, like you said though, everyone likes to dibble dabble, and everyone. Mm-hmm. It's cool to dibble dabble because that's a part of you finding out what you like. But y'all get, I'm not going to say y'all, let me include myself, people, we get so attached and so quick and think that we have this Mando connection that we have, that it's like you don't even realize there are more parts of yourself that have to be explored.
Right.
There are more parts of yourself that you're not going to like. So you need to go out and talk and date to these multiple people, but people want to attach themselves to one person. It's like you're trying to build something that's not even there to be built. The establishment, the grounding of it is not there. So why are you trying to build something on that?
Right.
But then still want to dibble dabble and make this pothole and make... No, we're not doing that.
Yeah.
Let's just realize what we'd like, and let's just go out and explore ourselves and have fun. And that labeling, oh, Lord, that labeling is a labeling, period.
Yes.
And if I take it there with everybody, bruh, please don't come for please don't come for me. That labeling, especially in the LGBTQ community, is out of this world. Y'all trying to look at me? Y'all trying to see me?
Hold on. Wait a minute. Let me put it up.
A fool. I cut
up. Let me see what your host look like.
I cut up. I'm bald head. I have a face standing at 5'10, 24, 32, 36. Okay.
Oh,
I'm just playing.
Wow.
I'm just playing.
Oh my God.
Imagine though if I knew. Let me find out what my measurements are. That's how I'm coming. Yeah. Every time you invite me to the show.
Okay.
So everyone has a cue. Dark skin, tattoos on the right arm.
Oh.
Left arm. Damn it. Shit.
That was the left. That was this. This girl is crazy.
Don't worry about
She's
it.
She's crazy.
I am nuts. A Gemini. Man.
Wow. I love it. So, yeah. So, we're talking about what are the stages and all of that type
stages.
Of stuff. Yeah. I only give people, you know what, though? I would say I get irritated real fast. So, you only got a little minute.
I listen.
It's just
the shallow in me. I'm just going to sound a little crazy. Babe, if you're listening, you made it past, so don't even worry about it. You've actually got real fine over this time we've been together. Nonetheless, yes, I love her. I love her dearly to my heart.
You know what?
I do. But I used to have this thing where I could be dating people, and we could be 3 months in that thing. We really chilling, just big kicking it, and we could say we laid up in the bed, and I turned my little big old head, and I look, and I start looking like, damn, dude's kind of ugly. Yeah, shallow. I have no shame in my game. Shallow.
You're kind of ugly.
You, that nose is kind of big. I know my nose. You know, I have but I'll be looking like, maybe I'm not into you like I thought.
Have you ever just, the listeners, have you ever just was shallow like that and you just looked at your partner and you was like, you know what? You actually really ugly,
this
though.
This is not it.
This is, wow.
This is not it.
I don't know about, well, yeah. I'm not going to lie. I can be shallow sometimes.
Yeah.
But.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, it'd be like that sometimes. I don't know why, but I do. I mean, I was. Okay, everyone, listen. Don't come from my neck. Don't come from my head, top boy. I'm not like that anymore. I'm really cool. I'll be cooling now.
Okay, you be cooling.
I'm good.
That's
I'm
good.
Good, now. I'm good.
Shallow
girl.
Is out.
Shallow is definitely out.
Yeah.
You can be a little picky. Just don't be a jerk.
I'm a little, picky.
I will say when it comes to men... Mm-hmm. I definitely am picky just because for me personally, I never had this full representation of a man or quote unquote a good man.
Okay.
So it's like type of man that I'm coming in and I'm out of my house and things are like thugs, they're hood, they're this, they're this. There was never the structure of a man. So I don't have this idea of like, okay, this is my ideal type of man. This is who I'm looking for. So I begin approached by niggas. And
yeah.
Niggas, but that's not what I want. So
yeah,
because that's not what I want, I just be like, okay, there's gonna be a man, and when that connection hits, boy, it's
what
over
do
for
you
everybody.
Think? You know, it's crazy because I've been attracting a lot of that. I would say, I mean, I attract a different, different ones. You know, some of them that have things going on. When I'm gonna be on the show, I turn that bitch up. Y'all born wow,
we're live, baby. They're going dumb with the whole technical issues and all. Still
Listen,
in this thing, turned up.
You're mean. Get off. I'm going to text you later now.
I got something to say for you later.
Oh, my gosh. But, yeah, I don't even know what I was saying now. Because
your idea, where you're at, with how you look at them.
Oh, yeah. I feel like I attract a lot of niggas.
Niggas. That's okay. Because, listen, I'll be looking at them, too. They look good.
They do.
Your men's, y'all hear me? Y'all be looking right. Okay, I've been peeping y'all.
They be a little hood. They be a little hood. I
come
like a little hood, though.
Girl, That's my kryptonite. And snatch me. Let me tell you.
Come on,
a little rough.
A little rough.
Give me a little rough, but you could put on a business suit.
Got a rough neck.
I don't know, but okay.
You don't know that, MC Light? I need a rough neck. I need a man with an attitude on. You need fingers with a suit.
Sorry, y'all. Don't listen again. Don't come from my head.
Wow. No, MC Light. Okay.
Not out of memory. Not out of memory.
Wow. She don't know.
Am I the first one to get the boo? Because that's okay. That's okay.
Oh,
I don't. That's okay. Listen, don't come from my head. It's okay.
Yeah, okay.
The blank stare and the blank look. Like, okay, sure.
Oh, my gosh. Yeah, we're having a lot of technical difficulties today. I guess it's
Even though the retrograde is definitely over. It's cool, though.
Yeah.
It's cool, though.
Hey, best friend. She joined the live.
Hey, best friend. Hey, love. How you doing?
Yeah, but yeah, I've been attracting. I don't know. It's like, I'm kind of like. See, I seen a post. I was going to post it. But, like, people always come for my neck, okay? They said, you know, I want a boyfriend, but, like, I don't want to have to train it, you know? And okay. That's just how I'm feeling.
See, but then here we go, because there's a population for y'all. Mm-hmm. There's a population for y'all who will, oh, I need a man, six figures, I need all clean white socks, all new Hanes, all Mercedes-Benz, you know, I need all this in my men. The whole time, you at McDonald's, walking.
Oh, the girls? Oh,
those are them. They be asking. Yeah. They be asking
it's
for
like,
all
what,
that.
What are, so what are we bringing to the table?
How are you attracted? How are you thinking that you're going to attract something like that if that's not what you're on?
Ew.
So.
I mean, yeah. I think we need to get our minds right.
Just a smidge. Don't worry, though. Men and women. Here's the thing that my partner and I were actually talking about. The fact that you can be a woman, mm-hmm. and let's say you're more of the masculine energy type of woman. And that's not saying like the way you dress, just how you come off. Like that's right. Just how you run game is more of a masculine approach. Exactly. Men will be like, oh, you acting like a nigga. Versus you have a man who's more in his feminine energy, more sentimental. Mm-hmm. Women gonna be, you acting like a bitch. So I'm just like, it has no gender. The right. game is the game and everybody's playing it. That's what everybody needs to realize. The game is being played from both parties. Mm-hmm. And we'll all be doing something. Some of us are a bit more masculine and some of us are a bit more feminine. But nonetheless, it's a game. You didn't get played. It's the game. You got to take that L. You got to charge it.
Charge it to the game.
Charge it. It's my favorite thing to do. Charge run it up.
Okay.
Run it up.
I'm ready. Hi.
Who that is?
Hello, ooh, y'all. Oh, my gosh.
Yeah, man.
So
We're just here. We're in the present moment. We're doing mental check-ins. We're talking
yeah,
about it all.
She's so cool. She's just like,
I just be talking, running my mouth, talking shit, yeah. Really. Gemini behavior, just be talking. Don't even, yeah. Talking right out my booty hole.
Not out the booty
the
hole.
Booty hole.
Come on now.
The booty hole.
You eating
booty?
Come on now. Huh?
Left field. I said it. You eating the booty and you getting
do
the
you
booty.
Eat the booty? Okay, that was on the whole. That was on another. Look, we can talk about everything on here, okay?
Okay. Because it needs to be under the sun.
Do I eat the booty? No, I don't eat the booty.
Yeah, I'm not doing it.
I am not a colon muncher.
Let me mind my business, because I was finna, have you?
What?
Someone touched your booty?
Has
I'm asking, look. Because if you don't stop me, I'm going to keep going.
Has somebody touched my booty? Licked the booty?
Has somebody touched your booties like groceries?
Oh, yeah.
That is the natural response, though. Yeah. They sure
but I ain't
was.
Doing that. I'm sorry.
No,
I'm
yeah, no. It was an accident. And I was like, oh, okay.
What's this down here?
And then, right. What are you doing down there? But all right. And we're back to it. We're away
they say
from
you,
that.
You ain't going to go too far past the gooch area. For me, I'm not going to go.
The finger representation. This, that.
Ain't it that? It's like,
girl.
The little.
That little pocket thing?
Yeah, I'm not going past. I'm not doing that. Because I just feel like men, I feel like men aren't really, I mean, I'm not going to say all men. There's men that clean themselves. But I mean, if you're not like, you know, really cleaning it out like that, then I don't really think
I'm
that.
I'm
talking about you need to be bent over and you need to be like, it need to be spread.
See.
You need to spread the cheek.
I wonder how many men are actually okay with that. How many men, y'all, if y'all are listening, y'all in the chat room, please answer me. The men's, y'all okay with that? Because it's okay. It's okay if you want to groceries. Oh my God. Go to work. Do what you do. And the reason I say that is because, especially if we want to, okay, we're getting a little deep again. We had the passing of Reese. He was dating a transgendered man, meaning that they were a man first and then they were a woman.
Okay.
Yes. And he
trans woman, right?
Trans woman. Did I mess that up? I may mess that up. In my head, it made sense. We are. Sorry, y'all. I may have brought it out of her. I'm not going to lie.
I may have brought it out of her.
But nonetheless, he was dating a man who had transitioned into a woman. And he was getting publicly bullied for that. And he ended up committing suicide.
Wow.
Yes. So that had brought me to the conversation with my friend, the one that was actually here. We had brought it up, the fact that there is a stigma between men being bisexual and women versus women being bisexual.
Okay.
And I feel like there is more of appraisal from women being bisexual than there is men. And she had asked me, she was like, do you think men worry about this disapproval from more so from men or more so from women when it comes to them being bisexual? And my response was, I don't feel like it matters about the gender. There's a shame in both ends, which they feel is coming towards them, whether that be from the woman, because a woman could easily be like, oh, I don't want to be with you because you like men. You be doing this. And just as well as men be like, oh, okay, you're gay. You be doing this. You're this type of dude. You're this. And it changes the persona of that person or whatever the case may be. But I definitely feel like there's more of a negative stigma for men to be bisexual. And it's not cool. It's not fair.
Yeah.
Because, and even for women, it's also not fair because sometimes being a bisexual woman, men are looking at you like, okay, I'm finna get the best of both worlds. Whole time it has nothing to do with you, dude.
Right.
Whole time I don't even want you. I'm on my women, or you know, whatever the case may be. But I think that's very unfortunate that in today's society that we place what feels good to us and we try to apply that to people instead of just minding our business and letting people just do what it is that they choose to do. So definitely my condolences to his family and to those people that are dealing with that, and to anyone out there who does not feel comfortable coming out in their sexuality. Please know that it is okay. Please take the note of myself of, I don't give a fuck. I'm going to do what makes me happy and what makes me feel good. So if you choose to do dibble dabble in whatever peanut butter ice cream you want to, go ahead.
The peanut butter ice cream.
Make it rock. Yeah, seriously, because man, people and their thoughts and their opinions are really, they're hurting people, and we shouldn't be doing that.
Yeah.
We should make people feel good. And if you don't like what someone's doing, just mind your business. You ain't got to say nothing. Close the app.
Mind your business.
We can't do that. We can't do that, and that's why the Amazon fire is on force. Fire is on force. Wow,
the fire is on force.
Wow, y'all. Listen, I'm sober. I promise you. Yes, that's why the Amazon forest is on fire.
Yeah.
Because we don't know how to mind ours and messing stuff up. You think we're going to be here in 10 years? We're going to last with all these global crises?
Oh,
global crises.
That has been the topic of conversation for a minute.
Yeah, it's a thing. It's absolutely a thing.
You know what? I don't know. I'm going to be honest with you.
I don't blame you.
I don't know.
I do not blame you. Me neither. Me neither. It's almost ignorant to say, like, you know, it just doesn't matter to me. But at the same time, it's like, I'm here right now. And
right.
I got to do something right now.
Right.
I got to make some of this right now. Be on something right now, because I don't know if we're going to be here in 10 years. I don't know what everyone's going to be
on. We don't know.
We don't know. And that's why, going back to what you said, as far as like just thinking that you always have to be doing something and where you should be at this moment, like take it easy. We got to take it easy and know that we are here exactly where we're supposed to be in this moment. We're supposed to be right here. Where else are you supposed to be? And that also, again, thinking of things of the past and the future and making full overthinking visual simulations and imagination of past and future thing, it fucks up your present.
Right.
It makes you so unaware of what's going on right now and unappreciative of right now. And that was a thing, too. It's like a race against time, but time always wins.
Yeah.
Unless you come to full order that everything is divine in its timing.
Wow. So deep. Why you remind me of like an Issa? Like she said, like, they not gonna admit, but they know they'll like that shit. I would do it for my husband. Oh,
okay. Who that is?
That's do it for Monty.
Hubby. Yes, Monty. Do it for hubby. Yes. Get open. Get fariki. Y'all don't know what y'all like until you try it.
I am so done.
You don't know. You don't know. And ooh, y'all nasty. The what y'all be doing, huh?
Ooh.
Right, I love nasty dogs.
One day I'm gonna have an episode with some real bona fide freaks,
and we just love nasty talks. I be trying to get nasty with my friends and tell them my nasty stories. They don't be wanting to hear.
If you are a bona fide freak, and you want to be on the show.
Freak, no. freak nasty, okay?
People always want to bring freak. Up sex and all that.
We can talk about have a nice
that's deep, what? Deep Kama conversation Sutra. About sex.
That's our most powerful energy. Yeah, I got a lot to say.
Yeah.
What? I think it is beautiful, and shout out to all the mothers out there. Mm-hmm. Fathers as well. The fact that we are humans and have the ability to create life, that simple thing just blows my mind.
Yeah.
It wows me every time because
it's amazing.
You have a little human. You're a human with a little human just growing in you, doing its thing.
And it grows up.
And it grows up and then continues another generation and then has kids of its own or whatever. Like, that is wow. That exactly. is awesome. Shout out to all the humans out there populating, doing things of that nature. Y'all are cool. Y'all are what's up.
Right.
Creating life, man.
Exactly.
Yeah, out here creating.
Oh, my gosh. Well, this was a very interesting episode.
Yes.
We had started it before, you know, it was a little muted and all of that stuff, but it's okay.
We gathered it back together.
Thank you guys for tuning in. I'm going to let you do your handles and all of that type of stuff, and then, you know, where they can find you at and all of that.
Yes, y'all. Okay. If you guys do have an Instagram, which I hope everyone does because those are important in this day and age, My Instagram is Justice Jackson with 2 underscores, completely simple, justice, like poetic justice. American flag justice. Jackson, Michael Jackson, straight up simple. Instagram for my podcast is Say Jackson. It is available on all platforms in which you guys can tap in, where we speak on all things millennial. Twitter.
Yeah.
Now, if you come to my Twitter, I have a caution in my bio, okay? Warning, this is a mild representation of my ego. So it might get a little outlandish. It might get a little crazy. But you've been warned, so that's on you. And I'm not putting my page in private. But you can follow me at Justice X Jackson. Again, that's Justice X Jackson. Mm-hmm. Tap in. Come talk to your girl. As you see, I'm willing and ready and open to talk about it all.
Yes.
Yes.
How exciting. Right. I just love you.
Yes, I love you too. Thank you for having me. This is exciting. Look, when I seen you got chose, I said, oh my God, this is so cool. I'm going to listen. Not only am I going to listen, but I'm sliding. Please shoot your friendship shots. So far, I shot my relationship shot, undefeated in this thing, 8 months, 6 months, however many months, either way, we're still in this thing.
Yes.
And now I have a new friend. Yes. And that's how I've been making actually a lot of my friends, just shooting my shot.
And just networking and just, you know, reaching out. People need to stop being scared.
Let's connect. Girl, don't even get me started on people will follow each other but not want to speak in real life. You can't follow me on social media and not speak to me in real life.
And not speak to me in real life.
Because what are we doing here? It's all one world.
What are we doing?
It's all one thing. There's no separation from Twitter, Instagram versus real life.
Let's be friends.
You don't even know who I am. That can make you $1 million, little do you know.
Exactly.
Okay.
Oh my gosh. Okay, guys. Well, thank you so much for tuning in to yet another episode of The Queen Pen.
Yes.
I promise I'm going to get it together. I've just been a little distraught just because of this whole window situation.
But watch and me I'm come just, back next
I'm
week.
Here. I know. I'm
just on fire. Hot. All my shit's together. How about that, y'all?
How about that?
Not okay. on me. Starting on time.
I can't even think straight, you know?
It's okay.
But y'all getting it live and raw, and this is what it is.
Authentic. Authentic. That's how I like it.
Oh, my God. So if you tuned in late, if you're still listening, and listen, steal the flyer, share the flyer on my page. I just want to support black businesses and all
yes,
of that
ma'am.
Type of stuff.
Yes, ma'am.
2 spots available per episode. I only
get
have
your
one.
Business out, people.
It's like, get your business out. Let's support these black businesses.
You want people
and all
to see?
Of that type of stuff.
You want people's money? You got to do that.
Exactly. Because
everybody's willing to spend, that's for sure.
And make sure that y'all come to this showcase. I'm going to post a flyer very soon. Once again, this is Brianna B on Instagram and thequeenpen.pod. Make sure that you just follow me and you get all the deets and all of that on everything.
Come get the juice. Come get the juice.
So.
Tap in. This has been great.
This has been real.
We have fun.
Oh my gosh, yes. I'm surprised that I'm happy.
Girl, what does that even mean? And on that note, y'all.
On that note, we're out.
See
Thank
ya.
You so much.